Hey, what's going on there, guys? To a very sunny day in Honolulu. We're on the ground here at the Cargo Bay area. And in front of us, we have the Queen of the Skies. And it's the UPS aircraft. Today, going to be flying to Hong Kong to visit the new Taxi to Gate Hong Kong V2 scenery. And it should be a fun flight. As you can see, we're right now loading. We have this tail stand behind, and nose cargo is loading as well, and side cargo as well. If you guys are interested to see this, don't think we see too many cargo flights being done. Anyway, we're gonna set up the aircraft. It's a 748 today. So not really much difference, but most of the stuff are newer. External power 1, external power 2. RS to nav, standby power to auto. Turn on the window heats. Packs can go to on. Logo lights. Nav light. Flight directors to arm. Payload. Right, so we just set up the payload. So today's payload would be a total of 211.3. We have to set the displays. So payload 211.3. Quite light today. Fuel wise, you're going to be carrying 119.816. I think that would be it. FMC. We'll also go ahead to the menu. Pre-flight. Today you're going to be flying from Honolulu to Hong Kong. Estimated time of departure. Oops, wrong keybind. Right now is 2251 UTC 2300. And estimated flight time is 11 hours and 5 minutes. Airline ID is 5X-Ray. ATC flight ID would be UPS 58. Got the mix. We don't need to fill this up. It's all done. Pass init. Just put in the reference airport, that's all. And the GPS right here. Route select. ACAS login. All right, that is done. So we can sync. UPS 58? Is it supposed to be like that? Kinda forgot. Kinda glitched, I think. Right, it's working now. Request sending. Do we have all the certain lights on? Everything is okay. Service interphone to on. Emergency lights to on. Altitude flight level 340. Runway would be 04 right. Route 1 is uploading. Runway 4 right in use. And departure would be the direct, so no sit. Activate execute, perf init, accept that. Just need to change a few things. Reserves would be 3.8. Step size 2000. Flight level initially of 340. Thrust limits. Believe it's takeoff, D weight of 2, and F 25. Flaps 20. VU2 will be 156. RNF, VNF, auto brake, RTO, passenger signs to on, not that we have any passengers. I think that is all for now. You can see the imaginary cargo afloat here. Don't know if it's a glitch. But we can go ahead, close the cargo. So the funny thing is that we have to disable the external power too before you can close the nose cargo. The alignment is wrong for the 74 set. Yep, the alignment is wrong, absolutely off. Might have to get an update for that. Right, I think we are ready for departure. We can request for push. So we have to close all the doors. APU can go to start. Fuel pumps, oops, to on. Beacon light to both. I think everything is fine. We can recall. Push back tail to the left. Move the wheel chocks. Oh no. I was wondering why there was a lag. Oh no. Right. That was a massive fail. Reset everything. Packs can go to off. And we can start engine number 4 and 3. good start on 4 and 30. Auto start in progress. And 2 and 1. Right, all four engines are starting well. Parking brakes are set. Engine. Fuel wise, no fuel in the center. Hydraulic to auto. We can turn off the APU and turn on all the packs. Engine 3 generator is open. Alright, that's here. Reset. Reset has worked. Non-normal complete. Before taxi checklist. NTR's checked, recall checked, flight controls, go over the stats. Flight controls full left, full right, neutral, full up, full down, neutral, rudder, full right, full left. Everything's good. Flaps to 20. Spoilers checked. Start the taxi. Taxi lights to on. Everything seems to be in order. Although one thing I'll do is to lower the volume of prepared. It's way too loud. Far right is just to the right of us, we just need to taxi to the end of the runway. And there's an aircraft approaching. Get the weather radar on, data, TFC. Just realized we are texting too fast. What is this guy doing here? Okay. We'll clear that. I don't know what he was doing. Runway 4 right. We can line up. T-cars to TA. Engine, sorry, checklist. Normal before. Don't know why it's messed up. Right, we'll stop here. Normal, normal. Before takeoff, flaps 20, checklist is complete. Landing lights to on, strobes, wing lights to on, set the range to 10 nautical miles. Right, 9,000 feet of runway. Here we go. Power. Toga. Trust ref, toga toga. Set. Airspeed is alive. Trust hold. And 80 knots. And V1 rotate. Positive rate of climb. Yep. Follow the LNAV. Right, we'll climb. Right, flaps 10. Flaps 5. Autopilot on. Autopilot in command. Flap 0. Recall is checked. Checklist. Flaps going up. You'll see the slats go up in a moment. All is good. Lights can come off now. But anyway, guys, I'll see you all when we are descending into Hong Kong. Stay tuned.
Like a bird on a tree, I'm just sitting here. I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together, it's so beautiful. You and me, we meant to be.
Yo guys, so right now descending into Hong Kong. Weather's looking not too bad. There's a bit of light showers in the area. So yeah, anyway, landing lights can come on now. Check the quiet, so put the spoilers out. So we'll be landing on runway 7 right, which is around the mountains. And let's go ahead and set the reference speed, just 131. Glide slope to on. And yup. You can see Kai Tak Airport there. I didn't install the scenery, so it's gonna be a blank piece of land. Anyhow, we can set to flaps 1. So the slats are extending. Set the speed to 240. waypoint limes coming up, and then we'll descend down even further to 1700, which is right over there, Hong Kong Airport, as you can see, right here. Speed brake arm, seatbelt signs on, auto brake 2, only thing left is the minimums. So minimums of 230 is gonna be set. 230 coming right up. Too much. Okay, that's done. Flaps 5. Intermittent rain. Flaps 10. Spoilers. Speed down to 160. Localizer to arm. And we can turn on the wipers. Updated speed, 130 is the updated speed, right.
2500.
Checked. Approaching. Get out. Spoilers. localizer capture, approach is checked. Go around altitude set for 5,000 feet. And speed down to 150. Flaps 20. Flaps 30. Speed 130. Catching the glide slope any moment now. Right, so landing checklist, auto brakes, two seatbelt signs. Sorry, landing checklist, seatbelt signs, all speed braked, is armed, gears down 3, green, flaps 30. We are all good to go. Glide slope checked. And at 1000 feet, we'll disconnect the autopilot. Hydraulic overheat system for clear that for now. System 1. Okay, we'll land this. Disconnect my aircraft. Not much wind today. You can just, you know, stay like this on the flight director. Maybe a bit too low. Just adjust that. With the cargo terminal off to our right. And 60 knots, minor braking, auto brakes off. Overkill here to our right. Spoilers in. Flaps up. We'll brake here and find ourselves a gate. Flight directors off. A I think we can park at one of the terminals here. So, taxi lights on, landing lights off. Strobes and the ring light can come off now. Auto brake to off, weather radar to off. The annoying thing about this is I don't have the wingtip clearance to go through here, I think. Why is the power so much? So we'll take the next right. I believe we all have the wingtip clearance there. So right here on Lima Terry. Another right. Charlie 19. UPS. Now you can park here. Take a left, and that's it. I'm just gonna stop here because the ground marking says to do so. So, yeah. Parking brake set. Forgot to turn on the APU, which will turn on now. Taxi light can come off. Runway turn offs. Nav lights. Logo lights. Beacon light has to remain on because we still have the engines on. Stats. APU starting. Hydraulics can go to off now. And the APU is up. Gen 1, Gen 2. Engine 4, 3, 2, 1. Chrono to off. 10 hours, 45 minutes, 59 seconds. Fuel pumps can come off now. And we'll open the doors. Not sure why both of the hydraulics overheated. Anyway guys, I hope you all have enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to leave a like and to subscribe, and I will catch you all in the next video. See ya.